Okay.
Faster than faster than the RTX 2080 Super on a 60s grade graphics card? But does it run Crysis though? Wait, this is not 2010. Does it run Cyberpunk 2077 though? Today we're going to be reviewing the Zotac GeForce RTX 3060 Ti Twin Edge OC Edition that is so OC that it just now flew away and then now came back. NVIDIA said that this card is going to be a beast for mid-range gaming as well as productivity tasks for professionals who are a little bit tighter on their budget, which is basically not me lah, because I'm never tight on my budget. Anyways, we're not just going to take their word for it. Today we're going to be doing some benchmarks for games as well as productivity tasks. I'll test out the CUDA and all that good stuff. Not the CUDA that you got, but the CUDA that is inside an RTX graphics card. Now that we are all caught up, I'm going to start apologizing to this box that I accidentally punched.
Sorry, it was an accident, okay?
New Year is here, and if you're shopping for a gamer, you could either buy a next-gen console, they're all priced around the same, if you could find one, that is. Alternatively, you could upgrade your boyfriend, girlfriend, husband, wife, just friend, or just want to be friends PC with one of these RTX 3060 Ti. Why buy a graphics card and not a console? Well, your next gen console is only last gen backwards compatible, while our PC is every gen backwards compatible. Eat that, Azrai! Well, you see, I hired a console gamer to be my editor so that I can show them that PC Master Race is superior by being his superior. See that? Mic drop. Wait, sorry, cannot. This mic more expensive than the graphics card. So what's the deal with this RTX 3060 Ti? How does it stack up against the previous generation 2080 Super as well as the current gen 3080? I cannot test 3070 because I don't have one in the studio. Honestly, see, all rhymes. Or AMD's offerings such as the 5700 XT because there's no 6600 XT yet. So it's pointless to stack it up against the current new offerings from AMD. So anyways, let's get cracking. Firstly, let's take a look at the aesthetics, and what we have here is two 11 blade fans that are black in color with metal Zotac Gaming emblems on top. The gunmetal shroud is made of plastic with black accents on the side where there's a Zotac Gaming logo illuminated in white and a printed GeForce RTX logo next to it. No RGB here, but it's okay. At the back, we have a black metal backplate that wraps around along two edges of the GPU to increase its rigidity. It also comes with rather tasteful cutouts that fit the entire sleek design motif. In terms of dimensions, this card takes up two expansion slots. It's 222.1mm long, 115.6mm wide, and 38.2mm deep. In terms of thermal design, what we have here is a more refined Ice Storm 2.0 from Zotac that comes with an aluminum heat sink with copper heat pipes that are directly in contact with the GPU. We also have the typical freeze fan stop that stops the fan when the GPU is idle, and the Zotac Gaming Firestorm software that allows you to adjust fan rotations independently via the active fan control and apply increased airflow selectively. But to be honest, I just leave both these fans running at the same speed to reduce any unnecessary disruption to the airflow. Now let's take a deeper dive into the specs. So the RTX 3060 Ti is an Ampere graphics card just like any other RTX 30 series GPUs and uses the same Samsung 8nm process. Specs wise, it's very similar to the RTX 3070 except for having 17% less CUDA cores, 16% less Tensor cores, and 17% less RT cores. It also has a lower TDP of 200 watts as compared to 220 watts on the RTX 3070. However, the RTX 3060 Ti actually has more CUDA cores even compared to the RTX 2080 Super, which should help it get better rasterization performance as well as perform better in GPU accelerated tasks for productivity purposes. Also, with the newer RT and Tensor cores, ray tracing should run better, and DLSS 2.0 is a lot better right now and should allow us to play at higher resolutions as we have shown with our previous RTX 3080 and 3090 reviews. Also, having less VRAM than the RTX 3080 would probably mean that you're gonna get inferior FPS at higher resolutions, but we'll see. Next, let's take a look at some special features that you might not already know about the RTX 30 series GPUs.
So here are the features that come with RTX graphics cards in case you're not that familiar yet. And the first one is real-time ray tracing, which increases realism in games by simulating light and shadows in virtual spaces. That's pretty awesome. Next, we have deep learning super sampling 2.0, which is vastly improved over the previous generation and allows resolutions to be playable on this 3060 Ti that would otherwise be impossible based on pure rasterization. And we'll put that to the test to see if that's true. So when we game, especially when it comes to esports or competitive FPS titles, other than frame rates or FPS, system latency is another metric that is extremely important to determine our overall gaming experience. System latency is the time that it takes between the moment you perform a mouse click or key press on your keyboard and the moment that that action is reflected on your display. Usually this happens because your CPU would create a render queue to ensure that your GPU is always fed. Because your CPU and GPU is not always in sync, this render queue becomes a backlog of frames that needs to be rendered, and this increases system latency. With a lower system latency, every action you do is more responsive, and that should technically improve your ability to aim and react in games. If you've ever heard of Peeker's Advantage, which explains a situation where someone's peeking around a corner to be able to see and react to a defending player in the instant before the defender's PC is able to render images of the attacker. With a lower system latency, this advantage for the attacker can be mitigated by giving the defender an opportunity to react earlier. So NVIDIA came out with NVIDIA Reflex, which is a proprietary tech designed to both measure and reduce system latency on supported esports titles like Fortnite, Valorant, and Apex Legends and more, where you want the lowest system latency possible for a competitive advantage. Basically, it works to keep the CPU and GPU in sync, thus reducing the render queue to lower system latency. Previously, to test system latency, we need some of those expensive tools that we don't have in our lab, but right now, with the new G-Sync 360Hz displays that come with a new tech called Reflex Latency Analyzer, you can actually test and measure system latency accurately and see how your PC responds to your actions. So we couldn't get one in on time for this review, but I'm definitely looking forward to test that out next. In terms of the test bench, we have our Ryzen 7 3800XT. The cooler is a Thermaltake Water 3.0 360mm ARGB Sync AIO. The motherboard is the X570 ASRock Tai Chi Razer Edition. For RAM, we have 32GB of 3200MHz DDR4 from Jill Superloose AMD Edition. And storage, we have 2TB of Gigabyte Aorus NVMe M.2 Gen 4 SSD, and the power supply is the Corsair RM850 80 Plus Gold PSU. Let's take a look at the benchmarks, and kicking off with synthetic benchmarks, we have 3D Mark. The 3060 Ti scored 7% higher than the 2080 Super in Time Spy Normal, but it's a little bit slower than the 2080 Super in Time Spy Extreme by a negligible margin. In Unigine Superposition, it is neck and neck with the 2080 Super. Do pay in mind that these synthetic benchmarks are purely rasterization tests because they don't utilize any of the RT or Tensor cores. Next, we have gaming benchmarks, and in COD Black Ops Cold War, with ray tracing on Ultra, the game is pretty much playable on all resolutions. Although I don't know what's going on, but we couldn't get it to show any significant difference even with the 3080, so this could be an issue with the driver or whatever. But as you can see, you can't get close to 100 frames in any resolutions but 1080p. We did, however, do a test with RTX off to show you that you could comfortably play this game at higher resolutions by sacrificing RT and still get insanely high FPS. In Shadow of Tomb Raider, the 3060 Ti loses by 10 to 15% in 1080p in comparison to 2080 Super. But it takes a small lead in 1440p compared to the 2080 Super. But in 4K, we see a giant 52% improvement with both RT and DLSS on, and double the FPS for pure rasterization in comparison to the 2080 Super. In Death Stranding, as this is a very well-optimized game, the 3060 Ti still does take a small lead over the 2080 Super in 1080p, especially when you turn on DLSS, but it is pretty much neck and neck with the 2080 Super in 1440p and 4K, and getting pretty close to the 3080 even in 1440p. In Cyberpunk 2077, which is what most of you guys are probably interested in, the 3060 Ti is actually neck and neck with the 2080 Super in 1080p, non-RT, but absolutely destroys it with RT on Ultra by almost 80%+. And the same thing can be said in 1440p, but the gap is definitely slightly smaller with RT on Ultra. In 4K, with DLSS on Ultra performance and RT off, we do see 35% more FPS on the 3060 Ti over the 2080 Super. But when you turn on ray tracing to Ultra, the 3060 Ti tied with the 2080 Super at a very cinematic hit 35 and 38 frames per second, which in my point of view is barely playable, since there's a lot of shooting in this game. Finally, let's take a look at real-world benchmarks. In Premiere Pro, the 3060 Ti takes a 6% lead over the 2080 Super, but this test is highly dependent on the amount of GPU accelerated effects being used. While we didn't use a huge amount of that, you can still see the difference right here. In After Effects, the 3060 Ti takes a whopping 41% lead over the 2080 Super, which is crazy impressive. After that, in our V-Ray GPU test, it takes another 40% lead over the 2080 Super, which is again crazy. Next, we have Blender Classroom. Again, we can see a 36% improvement on the 3060 Ti over the 2080 Super. And before we move on to the next segment, we did the Fermark stress test for over 15 minutes full load on a GPU. And this GPU actually performs really well considering that the size of the GPU and the heatsink is so small. So what's the verdict on this RTX 3060 Ti? Okay, firstly, let's take a look at the pros first, okay? So first and foremost, it has very good bang for your buck. It outperformed even the RTX 2080 Super that launched at almost double the launch price, not just in ray tracing, but also in rasterization as well as productivity tasks, okay? Even with the price drops of the RTX 2080 Super, this will still be a better graphics card because of all the new tech that NVIDIA has packed into this thing, and especially DLSS 2.0, which is now a much better implementation than the previous generation, allowing you to game at higher resolutions that were not available to you with a 60s grade graphics cards in the past. Also, here's a point, unlike during the RTX 20 series launch, ray tracing is now a lot better implemented in more games, and if Cyberpunk 2077 is any indication, we're in for a treat. And I do agree that ray tracing is the way to go in the future for better visual fidelity in your games. So there'll be more treat because it's eye candy. Get it? Okay. So here are some pros that are more specific to the Zotac Gaming Twin Edge OC Edition. Okay. First and foremost, I do like how it looks. It's very simple, gunmetal with black accents. Also, it's pretty rigid. That's a pretty given point, given that the card is this small. So yeah. Also, the thermal design is adequate for the 3060 Ti over here. It managed to hover around 78 and 79 degrees, although we were running it on full load with Fermark for more than 15 minutes. In terms of meh, the RTX 3060 Ti actually has a power draw that's closer to the 3070 as well as the 2080 Super, which means that if you're someone who's used to using 60s grade graphics card, you will now have to upgrade your PSU. And if you want to know which PSU you need, just check out our previous video to find out which power supply unit you need for your PC build. Finally, in terms of cons, I couldn't find much to nitpick about this card itself, and I would like to mark the 3060 Ti down for the stock shortage issues that make it so that most mid-range gamers as well as budget-conscious professionals that this card was designed for would not be able to get their hands on the 3060 Ti. But this is a product review and not a review on the industry and its preparedness to deal with the increase of demand in terms of work at home people or gamers. So I give this Zotac Gaming RTX 3060 Ti Twin Edge OC Edition, wow, so long, a very solid 9 out of 10, because it's definitely a beast for mid-range gaming as well as budget-conscious professional productivity tasks. You wouldn't be disappointed unless you need more VRAM or more CUDA cores for more intensive purposes. This card should serve you well. Also, with the updated Tensor and RT cores, ray tracing as well as DLSS 2.0 is now a practical feature that comes with your graphics card that you can actually benefit from and use on a 60s grade graphics card, which I thought was a lot better than the previous generation. So if you thought this video is awesome, please give it a like and share. Leave a comment down below to let us know what you think about the 3060 Ti, and we'll try our best to reply to any of your comments. I try to reply to every single one of you. So don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the notification bell to not miss out on any content from Mob House. Also, follow us on Facebook and Instagram to see more content like this and any shenanigans from the Mob House crew. And I will see you soon in the next one.